combat. Okay, I've saw you, by the way, and come back. Okay, let's show something I haven't shown yet. The communications mode. Now, I can't do anything in here yet. I haven't got enough levels. Nowhere close. But these are all for unique items and weapons. I believe that one in particular is a snowboard. So I've got plenty of extra challenges, if I so wish to take them on. No, even for Suya. He's here. Even Beep. I should be working. Okay, that's fine. I was like, why is that? Oh, subtitles aren't working because it's got a delay on it now. The mic problem has been sorted. I have put a small gate over the top of it just to keep the background noise out. So, we haven't got too many pieces of story mode to go before Shade Impulse. So, let's go through the moonlit twilight.
The power of darkness and the power of light. Within the Night Cecil dwells two opposite powers. One who values the bonds of friendship, Cecil, has been journeying together with Tidus and Firion. But he has yet to find a clue to the crystal. As the seeds of misgiving take root in his heart, a shadow approaches. Could the words from the dark emissary give hope to Cecil?
Yeah, Mike has been sorted. There is no background noise at all.
I thought if only I were diligent, what I sought would soon be mine. Yet still the true path eludes me. What must I do to find the crystal? The world isn't waiting for me to...
You seem to be in a pensive mood, Cecil.
Brother!
Lose yourself in the fog of doubt and reverie. And you will never reach the crystal. It will forever remain but a dream.
I lose my way because it is a dream.
What exactly do you think the crystals are? The true brilliance of the crystal is not visible to the eye. Casting about your gaze will not reveal a single mote of its light.
What does that mean?
Cecil, where are you? What are you doing?
If you want to know the secret of the crystal, follow my shadow.
Are you all right? That was Golbez, wasn't it? Isn't he sided with Chaos?
He's also my brother.
Be that as it may, he's with the enemy. What did he say to you?
He said he knows the secret of the crystal, that I should follow him if I want it.
Cecil, this is hard for me to say, but lower your guard, and the darkness may lead you to a trap.
That can't be.
Come on, guys! What's going on over there?
Let's go. Tidus is getting impatient. It's better to forget what he told you. I don't want to see my friend walk into danger.
What should I do?
I think that crop was originally meant for the Visual Boy Advance, but I may as well put it full screen anyway. And I'm noticing that emote for Sawyer. Is that a goddamn Yakuza like a dragon one? I really want to play that game. Cecil is a slow-growing character, but can freely change jobs during battle. Aerial HP attacks change him to a paladin, while ground attacks make him a dark knight. I've got him set up at the moment. Should have everything. No, I can use Sunblade if I so wish. So, everything at level 1. I have taken the liberty of getting more equipment as possible. So I have the Barblet and the Winged Helm. Shields, I think I have the Iron Shield now. With armour, we now have Chainmail, Iron Armour, a few more bits of robing. And swords, we have a few more. In fact, I have a lot more than I think. But, if I go into the shop for a few minutes, I have taken the liberty of inputting all the passcodes. So we have Excalibur, we have the Worm Hero Blade, there's the Ultima Weapon that just sat there. Valkyrie's exclusive too. Switch up to that. Oh, that's Ultimisius. Our Diamond Mace is Mateus. So we've got a bunch of those. Oh, no, Golden Staff is something completely different. Oh, we have the chicken knife as well. And a stick. I think it's a tactics reference. Just as legendary blade held by many. It's the same as the Ultima Weapon, except for... Yeah, it's the same as Ultima Weapon... Sort of. Ultima Weapon has one more attack and raises all stats by 2. Which is a bit different. There we go. There's a big old shield. Of course. Because Worm Hero turns up in 12 as well, I think. Yeah, so as much. You need the all the badges. Soul Eater. Poles and comes judgment. I don't have everything on for Cecil yet.
Beneath the light comes judgment.
Cecil is apparently easy to play, but I find him awkward.
I will not stop.
Burb. Burb is here.
My blade will lead me to the light.
So this swim's not taking damage. Okay. Against Cloud.
Forgive. Forgive. Darkness be with me. Forgive. Forgive.
Let's just punch Cloud so hard with the darkness that he becomes Sephiroth, I suppose.
I follow the path I must.
And Cecil is the only character to have 2 victory animations. Oddly.
My blade will lead me to the light.
That's solution 9. Not ideal. deal with, but there we go. I think most of Cecil's enemies are quite low level, so...
May you find peace.
I've already got Shadow Lance. The Dark Sword. Does that differ from Long? That is... Power of Darkness. That's it. Obviously need to find everything before I can put the equipment together. It is Shadowlance, Throne Weapon. And then I have to change, and there we go. Slash on the floor, radiant wings above. So you have to balance Cecil's abilities quite heavily. Still won't get a decent rank at the end of it though. That I can say with confidence. His faith is easily won. I like the fact that Golbez is probably one of the... he's one of the best written characters in the entire game. Doing a lot of weird stuff. It's the only pairing that sort of knows they're in this war, so...
This ends for you, not I. Target.
Yep, just throw my sword at him. It works. Very well, in fact. One of Cecil's failings is that he has very few moves which generate EX cores very quickly.
I will not stop.
Burp. We're trying to get all of the treasures.
My blade will lead
me to
life.
No. I tried the NT demo. Not demo, beta test. And the answer was, it's an arcade game, this is not what I want.
Darkness be with me. Yep. Darkness be with me.
I do enjoy the first pairing for good reasons, although oh god. So, Dissidio 012, not as much. Like, some of the changes I don't agree with.
Beneath the light comes judgment.
I appreciate what they were trying to go for with the change in, Duodecim, but it just rubbed me the wrong way. Weird Cecil's is.
Light and darkness cast along.
Best way to give my brain a hemorrhage.
A knight's path never ends.
The reason I wanted to do the original again is because, apart from making up, like, some extra stuff from a bunch of streams I had to miss while I had no internet, I just wanted to do something that, I had a reasonable amount of experience in.
How is this fair?
The labyrinth I wasn't as happy with in Duodecim, but the open world was a nice change. Just a pity that trying to get any decent weapons in Duodecim was an absolute slog. Mostly because of where they hid the Scarletite. A knight's path never ends. I was happy with the arena mode in this one. Sarin came in here yesterday and she was like, I really want to play this again and online. And I was like, do you really want to face me? Someone who is very in practice with this game. I would be very, very happy to fight as Gabran, who is probably one of the worst choices I could make. Just get some more experience. And keep going for him. There goes Golbez skiing away. I never bothered. Rails... What's the point of rails if I'm constantly in a one-on-one situation? I may as well dodge and run and... just... use the quick maneuverability that's not... that. Let's see, just this should be another dark item, shouldn't it? Yes, dark armor. Worth fighting you. Like, I find the movement options without the rails to be much more... So the glacial pace is X-Death. Well... X-Death you can make work without needing to use rails.
What you doing out here?
I was just thinking about what my brother said.
You mean that thing about the secret of the crystal?
The same. I wish I knew what he was trying to tell me.
Then why don't you just go ask him?
What?
That's what you really want to do, isn't it?
Yes. When I think about the risks my brother must have taken to come see me, I...
Save it, Cecil. You want to see him. That's all that counts.
But Furion was concerned that...
Who cares what Furion says? All that matters is that you come back in one piece. Let me worry about Furion, okay? Just hurry up and go already.
Truly? Are you sure?
Try listening to your friends more often.
Thank you. I'll not be long. You've my word on it.
Family... So, how will I explain this one?
Also, I've been streaming this for about five weeks on a Sunday, and I still don't know what causes that clipping issue. It just happens. Longer range characters have their uses. Ultimecia is a good example.
I mustn't coddle the weak. Target. Target.
I mean, it's surprising that Kane actually is in 012, but I mean, they probably had Liam O'Brien on call at that point. Ah, oh, dang it. Close. Let's go. Beneath the light comes judgment. For some reason in Duodecim, until I put together my main squad, my go-to character was Laguna. Constantly going up to the enemy, complaining, "Oh, I got a cramp!"
What's this?
In 10 seconds. Oh, and it's Cloud of Darkness as well. Out! I mean, I'm not going to go out of my way to stream 012, but if there's enough demand, I will do it. We had enough talk yesterday of... Was it yesterday or today in some other stream of...
A knight's path never ends.
Like how bad it was to play as Lightning. I think that was Sarin was talking about it, probably too. I'll lend you my light. Carbuncle! I haven't actually bothered to put on a summon yet, usually because the one that I use is a Marigar.
How is this fair?
Which is minus 50 bravery, a lot. I could clear it within 10 seconds, if possible. Character wise, she's unsolvable as ever. That's a damning of faint praise there for Sawyer. You better to have my toenails removed in hot oil than to play as to be around Lightning as a character. It's in. I have broken an entire toenail. That's an accurate statement. Okay, Darkness. We have the full set. Dark Sword, Dark Shield, Dark Armor. Wall Rush Bravery Damage 20%, Wall Rush HP Damage 20%. It's not actually that good. Sword. Shield. And Iron Armor. I am going to fact check you on that one, Carmack. You do realise this. Ali Hillis. Well, she's American, so there's always a first bullet in this head. Yeah. You never know. Sometimes people have interesting backgrounds.
Beneath the light comes this feeling. The moon leads me.
Also thinking that my next content anniversary, I might as well do Final Fantasy IV DS. Need them to play villains. All the villains, unless it's Jason Statham, then we always want him to be the good guy. It's like a lore or something.
So you've come, Cecil.
Why tell me the secret of the crystal?
And why have you come all this way? Most likely for the same reason. A brother cares for his kin. Cecil, I am here to gauge whether or not you are worthy of obtaining the crystal.
Worthy?
Indeed. That is why...
Bison!
Two lost souls, wandering in the dark. Or is this what they mean by brotherly love? I did not expect you to be bound yet to the other side, Golbez. You are a fool and a coward, longing for the light.
It's none of your concern.
On the contrary, feeble mortal. For it is I who shall punish those who betray us.
I won't let you lay a finger on him!
Cecil.
I don't know if you'll deem me worthy, but at least I can show you my strength.
So you would willingly defend a traitor? What fools you are. The both of you. You and your ignorance shall return to the void.
The void! The tree teapot is angry. But they're both so well typecast. I can't think of another reason that I would actually have as a voice actor for these two. It's a shame Gilgamesh is not in it until Duodecim. Though unlocking him is kind of a pain in the ass, from what I remember. I think you have to get, like, all the secret reports in the game before you can actually retrieve him. Shows that even a game I do not care for, my knowledge is, well, still roughly good. Got him. Who was the other one? Prish? Prish was the other hidden character, if I remember correctly. Here's a white mage monk. Off you go. Have fun. Let's go.
Beneath the light comes judgment.
Give me your bison box. Oh god, he actually hit me with the sword.
Beneath the light comes judgment. You'll feel it. The moon reads me.
I mean, I haven't played either, for swear. Let's just let me be blunt. I have not played either 11 or 14. So I'm like, oh, these two. Who are you again?
A knight's path never ends. My brother is not the same as you.
There is no difference. Light and dark have the same root, as do harmony and disorder.
Why has the crystal not appeared?
What's wrong?
You took on X-Death yourself, without depending on my aid. You've shown you have the ability to achieve what you desire. The crystal shines upon those who exhibit the strongest will. That is its secret. Seeing you as you are now, I thought you would be able to obtain it.
I only fought him. For you. Please, won't you join me?
What?
I must tell my friends what you just told me. They too seek their own crystals. Once the crystals are gathered, the battle will be over. Then you and I, we could...
Enough! I am merely your shadow. I could not accept the darkness, yet I do not belong to the light.
What?
You disappoint me, Cecil. Like this, you will not receive the crystal's eternal light.
Brother! Why?
I think I played as Prish in Duodecim, and I was like, okay. All you do is punch things. Combinations of punching things. Try and engage with the 14 mechanics that you have no intention of playing at that point, because the original 14 was... Was it Yasholta? No, not Yasholta, not Prish. What was she both named? Oh, Vieira looking one. No idea. Let's see if I can find it. Asking the wrong person, yeah. No, I don't want the video game cast, I want the list of characters. Oh, available after her. Xenos. What? Xenos? Oh. Yasholta Rule. No idea who you are. Oh, they put Ramsar in the home release. Yep. Yeah, I'm gonna say it quite flatly. NT was a mess. I mean, they added Vayne Solidor. Why not? You know, if you're going downhill. Oops. Oh well. Get the achievement for that. Well, the DP. I pulled up the whole list. I mean, Yuna was in Duodecim, so that doesn't. That makes sense. Let me see if I can find that. There we go, got all this. And 6, yeah, lock. Cade release and home release was basically the same for most of the characters. Available extra was lock. Rinoa, for some reason. No idea how to say this. Camelot, no idea. One from 11. Vayne being made available from 12. Snow from 13, and Arden from 15, along with Noctis, Ramsar, and Ace from type 0. What level am I? 12. Like, people that have played NT was just like, yeah, this is awful, and then me just looking at it going, I don't care.
How is this fair?
Like, Type Zero was an interesting game, period. But I just wasn't particularly enthusiastic about the choices. So I have an ability and I'm not using it. Let me see. Let's pull up Duodecim's.
A knight's path never ends.
Characters. Who's 14's representative? Oh no, there was no 14's representative. Prish was 11. It's one of those games that when they ported it, it was like, oh, well, there you go. It's on the home consoles now. It's been leased to the wolves. I think the other game that came out at that time for me was Odin Sphere. Odin Sphere was good.
The moon leads me!
I think because it was my first Vanillaware, I wasn't, like, particularly knowledgeable about what they did. So I was like, oh, this looks good, this plays good, I'll do. It's enough to pass the time. Not something to stick in the mind, though. Alright, let's go on desperation. Spear legendary champion would be Sephiroth. I have chosen poorly, but let's go. Extended attacks. Get out. I have done both, I think, at one point in my life. Oh, crap. I'm dead. Ow! Oh, I need to attack, and badly. Ah, and then he breaks me. Yeah, I think this is going to be a retry. I cannot seem to inflict much in the way of damage. I think Kingdom Hearts 1's one I've done twice, I'm going to say. Kingdom Hearts 2 one I only summoned up the courage to do once and then said, nah, I'm good. Your mechanics don't work properly, so that's it. Reading is quite bad. I'm just getting punched all over the place. Cecil has this really bad delay when it comes to his HP attacks, and I hate it. I have to just parry and riposte. I know my course. And then he does that, which kind of eliminates the possibility. I didn't mean to do that. That what? Darkness. Really need to know what Sephiroth's moves list is again. Other than the obvious. Oh, you've got to be kidding me. And then he breaks me. He's not even gonna bother. You can, theoretically, it just takes forever. really equipped a summon stone for this, but I might be able to do it. Every time. I was having this problem with, like, grinding earlier. Oh, you've got to be kidding me. How does he have critical on basically everything? In EX mode, I can probably do a substantial amount of damage, but it's... But this isn't a level difference either, because some level differences do have an impact on how much bravery and critical hits you do. Again with the Hell's Gate. You could just break through that, can't you, Sephiroth? That's fair in terms of a moveset.
I accept defeat.
This is unnaturally harder than I think it is. You have nothing.
My blade will lead me to the light. Target. Target.
Delay again.
Darkness. Darkness.
Oh, damn it. And then he gets straight into that.
Beneath the light comes judgment. Beneath the light comes judgment.
Get a straight critical. I don't understand what's going on here. I just can't get going. I'm constantly losing momentum. Centilia. Nope, pop slash.
Beneath the light comes judgment.
Oh, come on. Oy. I can't really retreat because I just lose more destiny points. I've already lost a bunch anyway.
Yep.
But why did I do that? Oh! Word.
I cannot meet the others like this.
I'm just getting pummeled in this battle. Alright, let's retreat for the minute. Oh, I received more penalties. Stop that. Can I reset the whole thing? Oh no, he'll just dump me back here. What abilities have I got that I can put on? Nightfall. Gotta have something for... Oh, I've got Sacred Cross. Does not help that much. Equipment's up to date. Yes. I don't know. I don't know why I'm struggling so much with Sephiroth. Okay, that's that. Getting faked out every time.
Beneath the light comes judgment. Beneath the light. Beneath the light.
Oh, shut off. Can I see? Time.
Beneath the light comes judgment.
And that was a waste of the X, and I'm screwed. I am screwed.
Is this the end?
I've already lost all my bonus points for this area, so I may as well just keep trying until I get him. One thing that could change this would be if I gained a level up mid-fight, which I don't think I'm close enough to. Oh, come on, I blocked all of that. Other abilities than this.
Beneath the light comes judgment. I cannot meet the others like this.
At the max I can get is 100 points lost for retrying, which I've already done, so. Okay, broke him first time round. I have a plan. Stupid one. And then I'm gonna waste it all. Oh, what the? Beneath the light. Come to this, you feel it. The moon leads me. There we go. Light and darkness cast along. Well, forward in the shadow. Any other character? I have an idea for Sephiroth. Cecil, I just have to get close. An uncomfortable level of close. Alright, let's see the damage. Oh, 60 is the worst. Oh, whatever.
I should return to my friends, but...
Brother! You came!
To set you on the proper path.
What?
You cling to the skirts of your companions. Is that the sign of a strong will? The crystal will never shine on those who always depend on others. You must act alone to accomplish the goal you have been given.
But I cannot abandon my friends if they are in need. All I want is for us to look for our crystals together.
So I see. In that case...
What are you?
Now do you see? The bonds between people are unreliably fragile. The friendship you believe in is nothing but an illusion.
Brother.
See that? I'm expecting movesets that I don't have. Oh, look. Yeah, Jack has found some cake.
Still confused?
Cosmos. I'm not sure of anything anymore. Not once did I doubt that we could find the crystals by working together. In fact, I believed cooperation to be the only way. But my brother, Golbez, says that I must seek the crystal alone. Have I been naive to think we could work together? Is the bond I have with my friends really only an illusion?
Do you look to me for answers?
Huh?
The crystal does not shine on those who only depend on others. What your brother says is absolutely true.
How could that?
Do not be troubled. Cast your worries aside. For that which you seek lies near.
What?
You already know in your heart. To depend on others and to work together with others, are they the same things to you? I know that you can reach the light. Because you are worthy.
Cosmos, does that mean...
The answer can be found inside you.
I must do this.
Only a true paladin will sheathe their sword. Was it flame armor, ice armor, and bomb? Very pertinent that, will not take damage. Again, cloud of darkness. That's not possible for me at the moment. I'm too rusty. Yep, there it goes. The movesets are very difficult to deal with in certain circumstances. I'm wondering if I've actually managed to get enough wins or battles altogether to finish Chocobo stuff. How many more does it require? 16. Excuse me. Light axe. Great. Battle axe. That's a serpent sword. Using plus 10. Knight should be fine. Knight helm. Have the shell armor if I require it. Knight's armor I don't have any money left for. A lot of the additional bonus items that you can gain from each campaign, you kind of have to do again and again when you've got extra levels and lives. They don't exactly make it easier though. There'll be rare battle pieces that will spawn that have a dish that give you 2 destiny points but are usually between level 22 and 34. One bravery break in 10 seconds.
How is this fair?
Is Ultimacia. So a lot of the reasons why I use the X-Burst is because it's more experience. A bonus each time you use one. Especially if it's an ending attack.
You fought bravely.
Just weird. Okay. Then within 10 seconds. Nope. Delusional Knight is Cecil again? Yep. It is me. It is the mirror. Oh right, yeah, Golbez is level 12.
There is a different air about you. You seem to have made a decision.
Yes. I will return to my friends.
What?
Brother, I do not travel with companions to cover my own weakness. Their presence gives me strength. They encourage and support me. I travel with them, so that I can aid them as they have aided me. A certain strength can only be born in the presence of my friends. That's why. This is what I believe.
It looks as though our differences are irreconcilable.
Brother!
You are a knight. If there is such determination behind your thoughts, prove it with your blade, my brother!
It's because I have friends that I can fight. Both light and darkness give me the guidance I need. Thus! I can turn darkness into hallowed light. Behold!
You're naive, Cecil. Even knowing betrayal and despair, you would depend on the whims of others?
I swear on this blade, I will not be dissuaded!
As a paladin, he can fly! Look at him go! And Golbez is apparently on a cliff. Hello?
Let us start.
Oop.
Darkness.
Let us start. No. No escape. Let us start. No.
Well, I just lost everything I made up. Oh, Cosmic Ray. That's the move I hate. Golbez gets it very early on.
Beneath the light. Beneath the light. Come judgment. I know my course. Beneath the light comes judgment. Beneath the light comes judgment. Beneath the light comes judgment. Darkness. Beneath the light.
One attack could end it all. Or you get close to him. Sorry, old man with a beard. I'll be able to do it. Oh, Genesis Rock.
Darkness.
fought bravely.
And I got his stick. Wait.
I see the strength of which you spoke.
The crystal. This is ours, brother. We found this light together.
Spare me the falderal. You found that on your own.
But...
this is only the beginning. Do your eyes see as far as the light shines?
Brother. No matter the hardship, I'll face it head on, together with my friends. And someday, with you as well. Because our bond is my guiding light. My mind will not waver.
Tiny Luna Whale. For Shinryu makes its move.
After the fierce battle with his own brother, light finally shines on the gentle knight. Whatever trials and tribulations he may face, the belief in the bond he has with his friends shall never fade. Under the crystal's gentle glow, he makes a wish that he and his friends might overcome this adversity, and that someday he might walk alongside his brother again.
Cube and Brit American. I haven't seen Brit in a while, actually. Well, streaming anyway. 73. Wee. There's the rare battle beast.
Time to save the day. And then I bumped into you guys shortly afterwards. And that, my friends, is my story.
You coming with us?
Guess what? The story continues.
Huh?
Not really three big heroes, just three heroes over the size of 5'6". TV catalogue. Let's pick them up. Golbez.
This too is destiny.
Don't know how to say that one, but he uses techniques that simultaneously strike physically and magically. Golbez is probably my preferred dark side character. Right. Oh, well, did I do on that one? 60%. Right then. That's to Mr. Depressing himself.
Destiny's burden weighs heavily on Cloud's giant sword. He travels in search of his crystal together with Firion, Cecil, and Tidus. But his eyes always gaze out to the distance, searching for what awaits at the end of his struggles. If he obtains his shimmering crystal, will he be able to cast a light on the shadows hiding within?
This one should probably go the fastest. Cloud is the most beginner-friendly character. Fate. Just another sadist with a god complex, like most Final Fantasy villains. Something darker. Cloud learns many attacks quickly and can adapt to a variety of situations. Deliver powerful blows that send his opponents crashing into walls. And the Zweihander is his weapon for this. So, can I do better than the bronze bangle? No, I cannot. Hat. He is wearing a hat. Yeah. Let us start going then. Into the blue fields, and his summon is Typhoon. Of course it is.
Let's just get this over with.
See, ground should be cross slash. And air is braver. Cloud in this game is the one that I use to beat the super boss because he's that easy to use. But then again, the super boss isn't exactly that much of a pushover.
Come with me. I'm ready.
Face fire! Look at it go! Be scared! As soon as I gain Omni Slash version 5, you know, that's it. Just game over. Quickest thing to use.
Come with me. I'm ready.
Oh, look, it's Mr. George. There we go. And he's just standing there for some reason. Ow! Big explosion. Just spam the circle button, man! That's how Omni Slash works. It's so weird that Terra and Cloud both share the same style of limit break. Just keep smashing the circle button. Although Terra's is left and circle, so smashing two buttons at once. Against Squalls is not much better. Use the R button in time with the melody.
Come what may, I'm ready.
Eventually, Warrior of Light will get his chance in the sunshine, but it'll be one I'm going to use very quickly. Smash.
Can't smile about this one.
Abilities, you gained another one. It's on the ground. Sonic Break. Well, I didn't realise he had Klim Hazard already, but there you go. And there's the Buster Sword, just in a chest on the first floor. Attack plus 5. Literally, it's no different to them using a greatsword.
Well, any clues on the crystal?
No. Nothing. So these crystals can save the world, huh? I wonder how we're supposed to find them.
We probably have to fight more. Just defeat every enemy we encounter.
Don't know if we should be running into battle without knowing what's going on. After all, most people can't win every fight.
I guess we gotta rest up sometime.
There is some truth to that.
It's good to have you with us, Cloud. You've the sense to think things through.
You can learn something, Cecil.
Look who's talking. Guess we all need some of that sense.
Sense? No. That's not it. I'm just...
just being a coward. Like, Cloud, as a measurement, is 5'7". Tidus is about the same height, which makes Pharion probably 6 feet tall. He's massive, for comparison. Yeah, Pharion is actually quite large. For the Final Fantasy II protagonist, he is the tallest. There's never been another Final Fantasy character as tall as him, strangely. Which obviously means that Yogg is about 6'3".
Can't smile about this one.
Yogg is tall, big, friend to all animals.
Come with me. I'm ready.
I'm gonna say Amaro's probably about 7 feet tall. Yeti's notoriously big, but I don't think he's kind of a runt one, if I had to take a guess.
there. Ah, over here.
Like, Sexy Umaro can only be so big. There's only so much of him to go around.
Can't smile about this one.
Umaro is 6'10". So Firion is incredibly tall for what he is. How tall does that make Zidane? Because Zidane is like 4'9". He's tiny by comparison. Zidane is the almost the same size as a fully grown Moogle in any other title. Without taking damage.
There. Ah, over here.
Give me strength.
Ah, dang it. Oh, what's that DP? Wait, Zidane's 5'8"? That can't be right.
This is it.
I'll fall into the shadow.
No, you're right, yeah, no, Wiki says 5'8". Just in this game, he seems small. Like, everyone towers over him and he seems like half the size. If I was any good as a fighter, I would have probably got probably got everything for this one, but I'm not. He bends at the knees a lot. Be more funny if he's just like that. He seems small because his universe alignment is not correct. But generally, most of the heroes are in that sort of ballpark 5'8, 5'7 to 5'9. Except Firion.
Can somebody tell me what the heck these crystals are, anyway?
Once we obtain them, will we be able to defeat Chaos?
If that is what Cosmos wishes, it is up to us to fulfill it.
But what are we... What exactly are we fighting for?
What do you mean? Isn't it to defeat Chaos? And bring back peace to the world?
Cosmos only said that we had to get the crystals. There's no guarantee that defeating Chaos will bring peace. Nobody knows for sure. What's gonna happen to the world?
I think we just have to keep faith.
We don't need to know much in order to fight, do we?
I just... need some convincing. I don't want to find myself swept into more battles without knowing why I'm there.
Cloud.
Can any of you guys tell me? If there's a good reason to be here fighting, I want to hear it.
A reason to fight. I suppose I've never thought about that before.
I'm settling things with my old man. But that's a personal issue. I know.
Good for you, Tidus.
Could you give me some time? I want to come up with an answer that would convince you.
An answer.
No, I am trying to look as hard as I can for Firion's height, and I cannot find it for the life of me. Found his age. He's 18. Been eating his greens. Okay, save every break. I have one of the types of Ultimanians for, oh crap, what was it? Oh no, bravery break, okay. I have one of the translated Ultimanians for art, but nothing else. Oh, hello, Fordona. Goes work meow. Oop, smash. We're trying to figure out Firion's height. Can you tell us? Oh, dang it. Never mind. Bye!
Over here.
What? This can't be.
Can't smile about this one.
Going 13. Seeing Phantom is jacked. Oh well, let's give him a try.
Come what may, I'm ready.
There, over here. There.
Oh, I forget every single time with jacked. Stuff is a bit weird to deal with. Well, that was useful.
Give me strength.
And there I go.
A loss is a loss.
Every time I try and save myself, I should really equip a summon.
There.
Oh god! Just been hit with a giant meteor blitzball.
Over here!
me something. The quicker I can smash your head inject, the quick, the easier this will go. Just wish I had other moves, as usual. Ah! Every time with Triumphant Grasp. Just this little fireball wandering around.
There. Ah, over here.
Ow.
Give me strength. Breaking my limits.
This is it.
Go now, just to build up enough EX meter for that other battle. It's Cloud's signature materia, fire. Damage. It means I can get that other destiny point. What? He recovered enough? Oh, never mind. Whatever. Okay. Just casually smack him in the back, why not?
That was a joke.
Ooh, yay, chest. That's the end of the road for that one. Finally. Hard edge. A good plan. I got a chocobo feather. I think that's the best one. So we may as well just keep changing the play plan around just to get those achievements. Oh, physical damage plus 10%. Bangle yet, have hats, plenty of hats. What's the bangle? It is power armlet. It's just a fusion, I'm pretty certain. What was it? Accessories, chocobo feather. It is 100% experience value. Breakability 30%. And you can only get those through the play plan. Cloud's Ultima Weapon EX Burst is always guaranteed to get critical hits. It's strange. It's the only one that does. Give me an elixir! No, I don't have it. Magic pot. General vision should be Tidus. Blitzball!
There. Ah, over here.
Also, Tidus' mannequin is probably the most inconsistent, because his is red. It's the only one to not be of a bluish hue.
I won't sleep well tonight.
Abilities. Aerial Fang. Diving attack, scooping above, scooping foe with sword, useful from above. Take the potion. Engage piece that is.
I've been thinking about why we have to fight, but I'm finding it difficult to put into words.
I see.
There is one thing I came up with. Convincing or not.
What's that?
Wild Rose. There's something I've been longing to see. That's the reason I want to end this conflict. Of course, that's all just still a dream.
A dream?
Yes. It's a dream I can't give up on. That's the reason I can keep fighting.
Firion. Will you fight me?
What?
I want to know. I have to know if that dream is really strong enough. Strong enough to keep you fighting.
But, Cloud. Understood. I'll take you on.
Cloud's dick.
Give me all you've got, Cloud. There. Ah, over here.
Let's go squat on this 18-year-old man's dream. Get to there we go. No, oh, he actually used lightning. Your magic is weak here, Firion. Well, it's weak anyway, but whatever. Whoop! I missed the end. Are you kidding me? Oh god, double trouble. That's a good move. Shield bash. I honestly forget most of Firion's moves. Usually because I don't have them. Enough EX force to just to toy around with theory a bit more. Or not, that was a dumb idea.
Give me strength.
Some of Furion's moves are actually really good. Just pity you don't unlock them fast enough. I'm just still amazed that that Braver went through the floor of the castle. I won't sleep well tonight.
It's not over yet.
Not bad at all.
Like I said, I won't give up on my dream.
Yeah, but I can't be like you.
Why not?
I've looked, but I'm still empty-handed. And without a dream, what do you suppose I should do? Sorry. Didn't mean to confuse you. Maybe what I'm looking for isn't here.
Cloud Senpai is such a downer. Also, all the weapons went on the floor. Suddenly back on Furion again. A meeting of Sephiroth and Garland. More talk of Shinryu.
Cloud.
The Piss Dragon.
Did Furion give you his answer?
Yeah. He says he has a dream. And that he'll keep fighting until he can make it come true.
Sounds like Furion, sure enough.
He told you?
Yes, although he was embarrassed at first. He says he wants to create a world where wild roses grow in perpetual peace.
Sounds so childlike.
Honest men have honest dreams.
Maybe he wished it on a star. What about you, Cecil?
I don't think I can give you the kind of answer you're looking for. But perhaps there is someone somewhere with an answer. Why not go and look for it?
But I...
You should go, Cloud.
You too?
We're rooting for you.
You really don't mind?
Just one thing. When you find your answer, you come and tell us what it is.
Got it. That's a promise.
I honestly forget what order all these stories fit in, but at least Cloud is before most of the cast that I've done. Part of me wants to say that Warrior of Lights is one of the final ones for some reason. But there is a specific order to this story, and I do not know what it is.
I won't sleep well tonight.
Like, Onion Knights comes before Terrors is quite simple enough. Zidane's comes before Bart's is. Some of it fits together properly.
Yes, I have to.
There.
pistol.
Win within 10 seconds. Yeah, that might be possible.
Yes, I have to.
It's bots. And he's gone to bots.
I won't sleep well tonight.
Well, I'll just go straight for it. Straight for the kill. That's one way of keeping foes from the X-Cores, I suppose.
Can't smile about this one.
A war rush within 10 seconds. Let's pick up some of the items. There's a free leather armor.
Yes, I have to.
There. Ah, over here.
Really? Really, Sephiroth? Don't push me, mannequin. I will backhand you. Every chest contains a unique piece of equipment to start on the first one, but then after it's just like, well, any random junks in here now? All I'm really picking it up for is for when I have to, if I want to do any villain stuff. Which, more than likely, is no.
Good to see you, Cloud.
Sephiroth.
Why won't you take up your sword?
Fighting you would be meaningless. I'm tired of taking part in pointless battles.
Then if you had a reason, you would fight anyone?
No. All I want is to believe in why I fight.
Nothing but a puppet.
What?
Then let me give you a reason. A dream is easy to nip in the bud. How pitiful to live life hanging onto something this fragile.
It's Furion's wild rose. No. What have you done to them?
So now you have your reason. Come after me.
I are disappointed. Sephiroth still has his shirt on.
Thank you.
What's this? Win within 10 seconds. Bravery break within 10 seconds. Not a chance. Win without taking 10 damage. Okay, do without taking damage. Silver sword's better. Silver bangles. Not even the bar boot. And I have nothing more in terms of HP. God. I actually haven't been through this yet. Shiva is bravery, friend from rising. Bravery matches yours. Copies opponent's bravery. Bravery shielded. Opponent's bravery is halved for a short time. Protect it from break. Bravery frozen. Opponent's bravery decreases over a short time. Bravery rises for a short time. Opponent's bravery is reduced by 1,000. Is bravery equals to the HP damage you take? Bravery doubled, afterwards quickly falls. I don't know, I can never get along with... Oh, and they take time to recharge as well. All of those summons once they're used.
Not interested.
The Omega is only one, but yeah, it's a powerful one, that's why I use it. It's the only summon I deem using possible because it actually makes sense. Ow! But at least I got the DP. It's a risky ass move though.
I won't sleep well tonight.
Rising Fang. So we've gone from Aerial to Rising. They're the same.
Guess I have to.
There. Over here.
Meow. Just plunge him into the live stream. Take him and drown him.
I won't sleep well tonight.
I could, if I fudge this up, get Typhoon still. So we'll see. Darkness, huh?
There. There. Over here.
Need a little bit more.
There.
Bravery.
Over here.
And I've got it. Well, I could get the Zweihander now.
I won't sleep well tonight.
And as I take the big sword, it is a decent reward after all. Oh no, this is Viander.
I knew you'd come. You always do as you're told. Don't you?
What?
You look for a reason. Because you don't want to be swept into a fight. But all you do is look. You do nothing to follow that desire. That is why you are so eager to make someone else's reason your own.
What's your point?
Your companions could get hurt, yet they'd still have the will to continue their search. But what about you? You're nothing but a puppet that gets swept away, unable to make any decisions on its own.
You're wrong. I just...
So, I'll continue to provide you with a reason. Every time you need one.
Shut up! I've had enough of being told what to fight for. I came here of my own will.
All you've ever wanted was to cling to old memories.
You're the one who can't let go.
That's foul of bitch, please.
Sephiroth! It ends here. Go back to sleep.
Accept it. I am the one who guides you forever. If it's despair you want, then I shall provide.
What I want most, I'll find myself.
You're nothing but a puppet.
Here, have all the budget in the world for the Final Fantasy VII one. The rest can go hang.
You ignorant traitor.
There.
I forget which summon...
Cut.
...he has.
Vanish. To the promised land.
Give me strength.
Ow.
Ready.
Oh, damn it, went straight for it as well. Wall of protection. Demon wall.
Ready.
Oh, yeah, I know. I don't know what's going on with that one. I've had to fix my microphone. Oh, come on. Good night, Fordola. Ow! Yeah, I've known since the start of the stream. I don't know what's going on with that. I've tried restarting them, tried restarting everything on that one, but it's just not... Actually, I think the website might be down. It's shadow. Not gaining it at all. No idea. It just isn't working.
I won't sleep well tonight. This is it. The crystal.
It is also what you most despise. Take it. And you will be doomed to further conflicts and never know why.
So be it. If that's my destiny. I live in my reality, not yours.
Very well. Every time your eyes gaze upon it, remember, you were only able to obtain it with my guidance. And I will continue to pull your strings.
I decide my own path. Even if I have my doubts, I have to find my own answer. And tell my friends, like I promised. Until then, I'll keep fighting.
Truth is what we make it.
Crystal continues to shine, brighter, with every answer found. The warrior has vowed to keep fighting, and keep fighting he will, until he can fulfill the promise he made with his companions. Etched in destiny, his quest for answers continues on.
Here he is, Vihander. I think in fixing the microphone problem, I have broken... Oh, no. There we go. It's now working again.
Shall bear fruit in due time. The ultimate mortal conflict.
As well as the absolute end of the world. Perhaps the only thing that is out of our reach is the whimsy of the gods.
One of the few characters that does not instantly get destroyed into dust. Kind of odd. Now let's pick him up.
Everything returns to the plan.
Focus Blade. Uses peerless swordsmanship to deliver precise strikes. I need to have a look at what all of these are. I know Sephiroth is no shirt, so let's just pick that up. Don't remember what Golbez's is. I think Shroud of Darkness, this is her green outfit. Is her green? She was in the final battle. Okay, I can pick up enough PP for the rest of for the characters. Let's have a look. Let's change their colour. I change the colour of. It's always good. Oh, I've bought a bunch of colours. I don't remember what they are. Just a quick arcade with Golbez. In his alternate costume. But you get a set bunch of stuff, and the items aren't particularly great for this.
Show me what you're made of. No escape.
Wait, this is his alternative look?
No escape. No escape.
Here we go.
No escape. No escape. Let us start.
What is your normal attack? Genesis Rock is gonna be.
Farewell.
Excuse me.
Time to part.
Oh, I broke. Okay.
Time to part. Farewell.
And the other one's Nightbow. Oh, but why does that have priority over me? Transcend the stars! Gonna hit him with two stones in the face. Actually isn't what I planned to do, so let's take that down so you don't have to see my boring ass background. Okay, everything seems to be fixed, running properly again. Which is good. Let's see who is available. Okay. Anyone got any suggestions? Just quickly. If there's anyone that they want to see that is streaming, because usually I don't remember anything. I also will say that I have no idea when I'm streaming next. Definitely not the next 2 days, because I'm having to negotiate new working hours. A bunch of people playing NT. Someone playing Opera Omnia. Let's see who's in retro quickly. I always like asking if anyone has any preferences for someone. I'll just go quick flick through retro, see if there's anything interesting. The answer, as normal, is probably going to be no. quick look through my Discord. See if there's anyone streaming that appeals to me. It's a dead night. Let's see if there's an artist live. She's still going or no? Nope, the answer is no. Alright, let's rate Solar Cell, because I have literally nothing. Currently doing some Final Fantasy VIII. Why not? Yeah, I don't, keep checking Discords and whatever, knowing when I'm about to go live. Because otherwise, you won't know, and neither will I, because negotiations. Except but there you go.
Is B4 is one.
Right, I'll see you all later.
B1 is
Take
two.
Care.